हेलो एवरीवन, विशिंग यू वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग फाइन एंड आई होप यू आर आल्सो कीपिंग अ ट्रैक ऑफ व्हाट्स हैपनिंग अराउंड इन द वर्ल्ड, स्पेशली इन टोक्यो ओलंपिक्स। जस्ट वॉन अ ब्रॉन्ज मेडल इन हॉकी आफ्टर 41 ईयर्स। आई हैव प्लेड हॉकी when I was of your age, maybe 2 years, 1 year less younger. I played hockey at the national level and I can understand what it feels like winning a medal after 41 years. So congratulations to everyone giving us this joy of winning the medal. Now, as far as our class goes, we'll start. Good morning, Sai. Good morning, Ganesh. Good morning, everyone. With the same instruction that I always start, keep your videos off. Good morning, Santosh, so that you don't see this lag in your lecture. Keep your videos off. If you have to send any message, send it on my Aastik with the name of Aastik. Two IDs. One is Aastik Udenia, through which I am taking your class. The other one is simply Aastik, which is only meant for your chats. Now, let us have a quick recap of what we had done in the previous class. I hope everyone would join by that time that we are having this recap. We had derived the three unknowns that we were looking for. We had derived the formula for time of flight. We derived the formula for maximum height, and we had derived the formula for range, the horizontal range. Now let us go back and see them in new light. The first formula that we had derived was the time of flight, and the total time of flight, the time it remains in air, is given by 2 u sine theta divided by g. That is the formula for time of flight. I hope everyone remembers it. We had already discussed this in the last class. The other way of writing the same formula is t is equal to 2 times uy divided by g. Now, why we are writing this, I already explained to you. I wanted to write it in the same form as motion in one dimension. And then we discuss the time of flight is directly proportional to u, initial velocity. Time of flight is directly proportional to sine theta. You increase the angle, you have more time of flight. Time of flight is inversely proportional to the value of g, acceleration due to gravity on moon. Time of flight would be five, six times more. Time of flight depends on vertical component, that is uy, but not on horizontal component ux. Now, these are the points that we have already discussed. Now, what we can do is summarize some more point that we, if you can remember them, that might come in very handy. So these are the points that you can remember. They are very easy to derive, but since we are talking about the time of flight, let us remember these important points. Number one important points. For complementary angles. Now, what do you mean by complementary angles? What do you mean by complementary angles? You must be aware, you are from maths group, so you must be aware of complementary angle. Sum is 90 degrees. Yes, Anak. Sum is 90 degrees. Now, what does that mean? If one angle is theta, let's cut it. If one angle is theta, then the other angle will become 90 minus theta. Am I clear? One angle is theta, why? The other angle would be 90 minus theta. If I call the first time of flight as t1, so t1 will be equal to 2u times sine theta divided by g. This will be the time period if the angle is theta. If the angle is theta, you will get this time period. But if the angle is complementary, 90 minus theta, then you can call the time period as t2 Now T2 will be equal to 2 times u sine of instead of theta, you just write 90 minus theta sine of 90 minus theta divided by g. This will be the time period if the angle is 90 minus theta. It's very simple. Now we all know from trigonometry that sine of 90 minus theta is always equal to cos theta. So your this time becomes 2 u cos theta divided by g. Am I clear to everyone? This time period T2 now becomes equal to 2 u cos theta by g. This is the time period for complementary angles. Now I can do some small things. For example, I can do T1 by T2 ka ratio. What is the ratio of T1 by T2? What is the ratio of T1 by T2? What I'll ask you, it's very simple. To find out the ratio of T1 by T2, what will be the answer? If you find out the ratio of T1 by T2, Okay. What will be the ratio of T1 by T2? T1 by T2, how much is T1 by T2, anyone? It is sine theta divided by cos theta, and you must know that sine theta divided by cos theta is equal to tan of theta. So T1 by T2 becomes tan of theta. So the ratio of complementary angles, the ratio of time periods, time for the complementary angles is tan theta. Am I clear with this concept? Can I have some raise hand? Raise hand gives me more confidence that we have understood this. Only two people. Okay. It's getting up. Shall I wake you up? Only 11 participants. What about the others? Let me start from Vijay Lakshmi, Venkatesh, Lata, Shriya, Vijay, Varsha, Harshita, Siddharth, Sana, Sai, Tanmay, Yashwant, Rahul, Padmakant, Veronica, Ganesh, Sanjay, Praveen. Everyone is there, right? Now, the ratio of time of flight is T1 by T2, which is tan theta. What is the multiplication? You can also remember this. What is the multiplication of time period? I'm always saying time period. Time of flight. What is the multiplication of time of flight? If you multiply both, one is this, 2u sine theta by g. The other is this, 2u cos theta by g. So you multiply 2u sine theta by g. Can I have the answers? 2u sine theta by g should be multiplied by 2u cos theta by g. And I'm going to write the answer in a different way. I will write it like this, 2 by g into 2 times u square sine theta cos theta by g. Now you would be wondering, you would be asking me, sir, why you written this? Why not simply multiply it? Why you have written this? Can anyone tell me why I have written it like this? I have kept something in the bracket and then I've taken 2 by g outside. Why I've written it like this? Can anyone recollect? Yes, Santosh, yes. This actually is the value of the range R. So basically, I just wanted to say that T1 multiplied by T2 is nothing but 2 times R by G. Am I clear? We have found out the ratios of the two time period. The ratios of the two time period is tan theta. T1 by T2 is tan theta. But when you multiply, you get 2 times R by G. Am I clear? That was my point number one. Can I have some raise hands for complementary angles? Theta and 90 minus theta, if you find the ratio, it will be equal to tan theta. If you multiply the two time periods, it will be equal to 2 times R by G. If you can remember these small points, you would be able to save a lot of time in your exam. And as I told you, JEE mains may not be advanced as such. JEE mains is more about your speed and accuracy rather than anything else. Now, important point number two comes up. Have a look at this. I hope everyone is awake. So now I will draw the thing again, x and y, x and y. Now I have thrown the ball, a body with the velocity u at some angle, and it falls like this. I told you the path it follows is known as trajectory. Now let us take some point on the trajectory. Let us take some point here. Let me call this point as point B, this point as point A, and this point as point C. And let us imagine that this height of this point is h. The height of this point is h. From A to B, it will take some time. Let me call this time as t1. From A to B, the time is t1. From B to C, let me say the time is t2. So in going from A to B, the body takes the time t1. In coming back from t1 to t2, from B to C, it takes time t2. Now, can anyone tell me, just by common sense, what is t1 plus t2 equal to? What is t1 plus t2 equal to? If I add t1 and t2, yes, Santosh, it is very simple. It has to be equal to capital T, which is your total time of flight. Will you remember this? Will you remember this? So this will be equal to 2 times ui by g. Ui by g is easier to write than u sine theta. So I'll always try to write it ui by g. Now, one more thing that you might remember, that you should remember, t1 into t2. How much is t1 into t2? Now you'll say, sir, we don't know how to get it. It's not very difficult to get this. I'll give you the result. T1 by T2 is actually equal to 2H by G. And then I'll try to make some points here. T1 by T1 multiplied by T2 is actually equal to 2H by G, where H is the height of this point from the ground. Now, again, you have to see maths and physics. They are good friends. They are like cousins. They are like brother from another mother. They go hand in hand. Now look at the coordination here. T1 plus T2 and T1 multiplied by T2. Does it ring any bell? Does it ring any bell in your head? T1 plus T2 and T1 multiplied by T2. Does it ring any bell? It should ring a bell. And what does bell it all about? The first one is sum. And the other one is product. Sum of roots and product of roots. Do you now recollect? Sum of roots, product of roots. Have you heard about this term? Yes, you would have heard about this term in a question or a topic known as, yes, Jasmine, minus B by A and C by A, yes, quadratic equation. Actually, this phenomena, this equation, T1 plus T2, two roots, T1 multiplied by T2, actually comes from a quadratic equation. That is why the answer is coming like this. Am I clear? They are roots of a quadratic equation. The roots of a quadratic equation, and that is your homework to find out that equation and how do I get that equation. So that is your homework. So mark your homework. Your homework is to find out how do I get this quadratic equation. How do I get this quadratic equation? How do I get this quadratic equation that gives me the sum of roots or the product of roots? And then you will check how maths and physics go hand in hand. Okay, I leave this for you. Probably I'll make a video of this and put it on your group. Why it is the sum of roots and why it is the product of roots. If I get time, I'll do that. Else, we'll discuss it in the next class if possible. So that was about the time of flight. We have discussed what time of flight is. We have seen on what all factors this time of flight depends on. We have also seen the time of flight for complementary angles. just to make a point that you must remember this, and we have seen the product and the sum of time taken to reach one particular point, and we were very clear how we get this. So shall I move forward? Time of flight is done. Let us now move on to the second thing, the second formula that we had derived. And the second formula that we had derived was Hmax, the maximum height attained by the particle. Can anyone remember this? What was the maximum height which was attained by the particle while it was going up? That was point A. On that point, the vertical velocity became zero. What was the formula? We had derived it in the last class. You must remember these formulas, beta. There is nothing saving you if you don't remember this formula. Yes, someone remembers it. Great. The formula was simply u square sine square theta divided by 2g. Do we recollect this formula? Do we recollect this formula? Can I have some raised hand that we recollect this formula, sir? U square sine square theta by 2g. Great, great, great. Jasmine, I think you are new in the class, but still your participation is great. I hope other students also take hint from you, inspiration from you, as I have taken inspiration from the hockey team today. Keep on fighting. They were down 1-3, down and out. They fought back and they won. Fight back. That is the lesson of the, that is the moral of the story. Hmax is u square sine square theta by 2g. I can write it in a different form. I can write it as my favorite. And what is my favorite? Uy ka square divided by 2g. Uy ka square divided by 2g. Now, why I've written this? Again, there is a logic that I have used less alphabets. Less alphabets means less time. Less time means I have saved time. There is one more reason that I've written it like this, and you might recollect. We had done question in motion under gravity in the first chapter where we had thrown something vertically up with a velocity u. It reaches the maximum height. This was point A. This was point B. And this was the maximum height. Do we recollect this? Hmax. This was the maximum height, Hmax. And if you recollect the time taken in this case, and we have discussed this in the previous class, will always come as u by g. Do we remember this? The time of flight in this case was always u by g. We discussed this in the last class. Yes or no? Can I have some reason? Yes, sir, we remember this. Time of flight, we were discussed in the last class. It was u by g. Now, we're also seeing that why I have written the time of flight for a projectile as 2 times u by g, so that I can correlate both the motion in 1D and motion in 2G. I returned 2 times uy by g, and then I told you that beta, both of these are same things. In equation number 1, the vertical velocity was u. In equation number 2, the vertical velocity was uv. So both the formulas are same. Yes or no? Yes or no? Do we remember this? That is why I returned this in the form of uy, so that you remember this from motion in 1D as well as motion in 2D. Jasmine, well done. Similar to that, if I calculate Hmax, v square is equal to u square plus 2as or whatever formula I put, I will always get Hmax. I will always get Hmax as, anyone? Hint, it's right there on the board. I have not discussed this when I was discussing motion in 1D because I wanted you to use equation. I did not want to use small shortcuts. But I wanted you to understand that if these shortcuts are made from the equation only. What was the formula for Hmax? What will be the formula for Hmax? V square, V is 0, U is U, minus plus 2As, acceleration is G. If you do this by formula, you will always get this answer, U square by 2G. Am I clear? Am I clear? When you go through all this formulae, you will always end up with this answer. Hmax is u square by 2g. Now look at here. We are in oblique projectile. We are in oblique projectile. What formula are we getting? Hmax, we are getting as uy square by 2g. Now I ask you this question. Are these formulae, formula number 3 and formula number 4, formula number 3 and formula number 4, are they different? Formula number 3 and formula number 4, are they different? Are they different? Tell me, are they different? No. Yes, Santosh. Yes, Anak. No, they are not different, beta. Yes, Vaini, they are not different. They explain the same thing. They always tell us the maximum height is u square by 2g, where u or uy is the vertical component of velocity. It was same in motion under gravity. It is also same here when we are talking about oblique projectile, the projectile which is thrown at an angle. Can I have some raise hand? I'm going to lower all your hands. Let's all raise hand and be in harmony. Let me understand this, sir. Nothing has changed. The only thing that has changed is that we are now dealing with two axes. One is x, one is y. Previously, we were only dealing with one axis. I only have 14 raise hands. That's not good enough. Sharda, Sana, Siddharth, Sai, Harshita, Varsha, where are you guys? Srilata, Vijayalakshmi, I never hear from you, Vijayalakshmi. Padma Khan, never hear from you as well. Sanjay, Ganesh, Praveen, Likita, Tanishka, Kevin, where are you? Jay Shankar, Sumant, Saitarun, Anil, Venu, Anjali, where are you? Okay. Clear, everyone? Got some messages in the chat. Let me check. Yes, yes, Goli, we will see that final match. Don't worry. But let us now, it's not here during your class time. Somewhere afterwards, we'll watch it. Okay, now let us think about this point. Good morning, Suman. Let us think about this point. Let us focus. See, remember one thing, beta. There is a saying, I mean, some students or some teachers or some people think that they can multitask. Now, what do you mean by multitasking? By multitasking, we mean that we can do many things at the same time. No, this is a myth. Human brain can't multitask. If you're doing 3 or 4 things at the same time, you are thinking that you're doing at the same time. You are doing only one thing at the same time. Your mind can only concentrate on one thing at the same time. So while we are studying, while we are in class, let us not think about what is happening in the universe. Let us all concentrate on the class. While you are driving and you get a phone call and you just see here for a split second, the next second, you are going to face an accident. Your brain can't multitask. When you are playing cricket and you see someone in the stand, you're looking at her or him, you'll get bored. Your brain can't multitask. While we are in class, let us all pay attention to class. If we pay attention to the class, even in 1 hour, we'll be able to study what others can't do in 7 hours. 1 hour is equal to 7 hours. 1 hour of concentration is equal to 7 hours of distraction. So where was I? We were discussing about the finer points of getting the value of H max. Now let us think what all factor H max depends on. We are only going to see H max is directly proportional to U squared. Yes, Vaini. That means if I double my velocity, keeping everything else constant, if I double my velocity, what will happen to the maximum height? What will happen to the maximum height if I double my velocity? The maximum height becomes 4 times. Yes, Jasmine. It will not increase. You have to say how much time it will increase. It is squared. So if I double the velocity, my maximum height becomes 4 times. If I triple my velocity, it becomes 9 times. If I make it 4 times my velocity, then my maximum height will become 16 times. Am I clear? Am I clear with this concept of it is proportional to u squared? It is very evident here. It's very evident here. Okay. Let us talk about the next point. H max is proportional to sine squared theta. H max is proportional to sine squared theta. Sine squared theta. Always be careful when you are dealing with angles because you might make a stupid mistake, a mistake of this kind. For example, if the angle is say 30 degrees, now sine of 30 is half. Sine squared of 30 is 1 by 4. Now I double the angle. I double the angle. Listen to me very carefully. If you cannot write, don't write. Listen, your mind can't multitask. You can write the notes afterwards. I'll send you this. If I double the angle, so it becomes 60 degrees, sine of 60 degrees. Sine of 60 degrees is root 3 by 2. Sine square of 60. Sine square of 60 is 3 by 4. Remember, don't get confused. If you double the angle, in this case, the velocity does not become 4 times. It becomes 3 times because it depends on sine squared of that angle. Am I clear? So if I double my angle from 30 to 60, my velocity does not become 4 times. It only becomes 3 times. So 4 will be an option. And there's a question that came actually. That's why I'm doing it. I made this question sometimes back and, you know, everyone got bamboozled. And they, as soon as you see 2 and you see V, maximum IQ just mark 4. It's going to be square times. This is the catch. This is how you get fooled. So Hmax depends on sine squared theta. Remember that Hmax, third point, is inversely proportional to 1 by G. Again, this is one catch point that since everything is squared, you might wrongly feel that G is also squared, G is not squared. So if I go to moon, and if I can throw something up on Earth 5 meters on moon, I should be able to do it 30 meters. Again, poetry in motion will remain in air for a long time, 6 times more. It will also reach maximum height 6 times more. Am I clear? Am I clear with this concept? Can I have some raised hand that you understand this, sir? Again, Hmax only depends on, look at the second question, look at the second point. It only depends on vertical velocity. Hmax only depends on vertical velocity and not on horizontal one. Am I clear? So if I change my horizontal velocity, of projection, but I keep my vertical velocity same, my maximum height and time of flight both will remain same. Time of flight and maximum height does not depend on horizontal velocity. It only depends on vertical velocity. Now a question, general knowledge question, and again it is the forced move. Time does not depend on horizontal velocity. Maximum height does not depend on horizontal velocity. Is there anything that will depend on horizontal velocity? Time does not depend on horizontal velocity. Maximum height also does not depend on vertical velocity. Is there anything else? Or there would be nothing that will depend on horizontal velocity. So whatever horizontal velocity I throw, everything will remain same. Will that happen? Can that happen? That nothing depends on horizontal velocity. Horizontal velocity is just a term which has got no meaning at all. It does not change anything. Horizontal velocity does not change anything. You throw it anyway, everything will remain same. Will that happen? Obviously, it will not happen. Something will depend on horizontal velocity as well. What is that thing that depends on horizontal velocity apart from the vertical one? What is that term that depends on horizontal velocity? Anyone with an answer? Range, yes. The horizontal range that depends on horizontal velocity. Horizontal range depends on horizontal velocity, and that is what we are going to discuss now. The third point. Third point is the horizontal range, or R, or simply range for that matter. What was the formula for horizontal range? It was very simply 2 times u squared sine theta cos theta by g. Never forget this formula, beta. This is one of the fundamental formulas that you must remember. How many of you remember this? How many of you remember this? Okay, with time, most of you will remember this. Let me call now. This formula can be written in many ways. Okay, Jasmine, she is quite active. I like the emoji, that one. Good one. I can't make emojis. I'm very bad at emojis. Sometimes I was in a chat with a friend and, you know, I wanted to say that I'm very happy or whatever. I sent the emoji and that was the actual opposite of my feeling. And they said, what's happening with you? Why are you sad? I said, I'm not sad, I'm happy. But the emoji was wrong. Anyways, this is one way of writing range. 2 times u squared sine theta cos theta by g. Is this the only way? Obviously, this is not the only way. So we'll try to write it in different ways. Jasmine, can you tell me, is there any other way of doing it? The more we talk, the more we chat, the better the class becomes and the more interesting it becomes. Now, what are the other ways in which you can write this? What I'm going to do here, I'm going to draw. I think what Jasmine is saying is what I am doing here. I can take these terms out. 2 times sine theta cos theta. I hope everyone can see this. Let me also do some stupid color filling. Yes, highlighting we call it. 2 times sine theta cos theta. Anyone remembers what is 2 times sine theta cos theta? You are a math kid. You must remember this 2 times sine theta cos theta is definitely equal to sine of 2 theta. Do we remember this sine of 2 theta? Sine of 2 theta. Yes, correct. So now I have another way of writing range. Range would be equal to u square sine 2 theta divided by g. Am I clear? This you can call as the second way of writing the range. So it depends on u square. If I double the velocity, it becomes 4 times. It depends on twice of the angle theta. So again, complications will come there. It is inversely proportional to g. You go on moon, your range will become 6 times of what it is on Earth. My question again, is this the only 2 ways of writing the range? We have written time of flight in 2 ways. We have written h max in 2 ways. Yes, Jagdish, you are there. I hope you have gone through the notes and that is very... Jagdish, how did you know it? Did you go through the notes or were you knowing it beforehand coming to the class? If you know it beforehand, that's amazing. If you've gone through the notes, that's amazing as well because you have learned, you have done the review part. Yes, Jagdish, I did not get you. You had done it before? Did not get your message, I think. Notes, great, Jagdish, good one. As I say, almost 95 to 97 to 98 to 99% of things are there in the note. But yeah, you should come to the class. You know, I am also not that boring, right? Okay, now let us look at the different ways in which I can still write it. Let's look at this way first. R is equal to ux multiplied by t. R is equal to ux multiplied by t. Someone should remember that we have arrived at this equation while we were discussing the derivation of range and time of flight. Do we recollect this? R is equal to ux into t. Do we recollect this? Yes. Do we recollect this? We had done it while we were doing. So this is equation number 3, where ux definitely means the initial velocity, that is u cos theta. And t is definitely time of flight, which is 2 times u sine theta by g. Okay. Now I can write it like this. So it is u cos theta multiplied by t. So I can call this as one more way of writing the same thing. Why I'm doing this, sir? Why are you wasting so much time in writing in different ways? Because in exam, the question could be based on any of these. If you remember these small things, this is going to help you a lot in the final exam. And now I'm going to substitute the value of t, and I'm going to write it like this, ux, and I'm going to write time as 2 times uy by g. So my final answer becomes range is equal to 2 times ux uy by g. So I've given you almost all the different forms in which you can write the time of flight. Now you can take your pick, whatever you feel like. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all are there on your screen. 5 is a bit on the downside. 1, 2, 3, 4 are on your screen now. Different ways of writing the same thing. If you can remember any of these, you should be able to get the rest of this. Now from this, we can understand that time of flight, the range R depends on ux as well as, it depends on horizontal component as well as the vertical component. Time of flight and maximum height, they were only depending on the vertical component, but our last hero number 3, range, it depends on the horizontal component as well. Do we understand this? Let me lower all hands. Can I have some show of strength? That we understand this, sir. Swati, Shriya. Okay, great, great. What about others? What are the one who is not Dragon Pro PFT? Venkatesh, Srilata, Pavan, Shashank, Varsha, Harchita, Surendra, Siddharth, Sai, Tanmay, Reddy, Yashwan, Padmakan, Naidu, Praveen, Saina, Tikita, Yashwan Kore, Honda, Kevin, Hannah, Goli, Sumant, Kartik, Bhavna, Ashish. Are you all there? Right? You're awake. Clear. Okay. So range depends on horizontal as well as vertical velocity. Now let us do some important points about all this. Important points. And as always, number one is for complementary angles. Complementary angles means if one angle is theta, the other angle is 90 minus theta. For complementary angles, anyone can tell me what will happen to the range for complementary angles? I keep the rest of the things same. What happens for complementary angles? Let me write the value of range R1. 2 times, okay. I will not write in the formula. 2 times, I will write it as u square sine 2 theta by g. So this is the horizontal range for angle theta. Now I will write the horizontal range for angle 90 minus theta. So it will be u square sine of 2 times 90 minus theta. Now, since you are math guys, you must be able to tell me that sine of 2 times 90 minus theta will become sine of 180 minus 2 theta, and that will be equal to u square sine 2 theta by g. Am I clear? What have I said? So the range second will also come as u square sine 2 theta. Range one is also coming same. That means for complementary angles, range would be equal or same. So if you have complementary angles, the range would be same or equal as what is shown here in your notes. And I will just go to your notes and show it to you here. I hope you all can see this. Height and time of flight are different for complementary angles, but the range remains same. As you can see, there is a small toy car or whatever it is trying to hit a toy ship. Two angles, 30 degrees and 60 degrees. Now looking at the graph, can you tell me the velocities are same, the magnitude of velocity is same, but angles are different? And as you can see, for 30 degrees and for 60 degrees, in which case do you think time of flight is more? 30 degrees or 60 degrees? In which case the time of flight is more? Anyone? 60 degrees, you can see sine of 60 is more, so it will go more up, and hence it takes more time to come down, and hence the time of flight is more. What about maximum height? You can definitely see in which case is the maximum height more, or in which case is the maximum height less. Definitely in case of 60 degrees, maximum height is more, and in case of 30 degrees, maximum height is less. One more question. How much more maximum height is? You have already done that. Maximum height is proportional to sine square theta. So from 30 to 60, it becomes 3 times. So it should be 3 times. The maximum height must be 3 times. But you see, the range is same. They are hitting the same distance on ground. Horizontal range is same. So for complementary angles, horizontal range is same, but the time of flight and maximum height are different. Am I clear? Do we understand this by the graphic that I showed you, by the photograph that I showed you, by the picture that I showed you? Okay. So for complementary angles, our range remains same. Now, one more thing that you must do, and we must discuss, is Rmax. Rmax. Rmax is also known as maximum range. Now, imagine that you are playing cricket, T20, IPL, and you want to hit the ball across the boundary for a 6 maximum. Obviously, if you hit it more speed, it will go higher, it will go farther. If you hit it at a angle, it will go farther. But for one particular angle, for a given speed, the range is going to be maximum. For one particular speed, for one particular angle, the range is going to be maximum. Now let us look at the formula of range. Range is u squared sine 2 theta by g. Now if I keep these two things constant, I cannot change g unless and until I go on moon, and I'm keeping u constant. Range depends on only one thing. And what is that thing? It is the value of sine 2 theta. Now sine 2 theta or sine theta, the maximum value of sine theta, the maximum value of sine theta is how much? For any sine, what can be the maximum value? The maximum value is 1. And it happens when 2 theta is 90 degrees. That implies that theta is 45 degrees. Am I clear? Am I clear? That simply means that if for a given velocity, I throw something at an angle of 45, if for a given velocity, I throw something at 45, the range would be maximum. The angle of projection 45 degrees, which is exactly half of 0 and 90, the range would be maximum. And how much will be that maximum range? This thing becomes 1. So what will be the maximum range? The maximum range would be u squared by g. And this is one thing that you should remember. Maximum range is u squared by g. Am I clear? Am I clear? Now, what would be the maximum height? What would be the maximum height if the angle is 45 degrees? What would be the maximum height if the angle is 45 degrees? It would be u squared sine squared 45 divided by 2g. Yes or no? Hmax for 45 degrees. Hmax for 45 degrees will be u squared sine 45 divided by 2g. Sine square 45. Sine 45 is 1 by root 2. Sine square 45 becomes 1 by 2. So this becomes u squared by 4g. Is everyone there with me? Is everyone there with me? What I have done here? I have found the maximum range and maximum height at 45 degrees. One is coming as u square by g, the other one is coming as u square by 4g. I can find the ratio. I can find the ratio range maximum at 45 degrees divided by maximum height at 45 degrees. How much is that? How much is that? Maximum range, which is at 45 degrees, divided by maximum height, which is at 45 degrees. How much is that? How much is that? That is definitely equal to 4. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Right. Okay. One more thing that you must remember, for any other angle, for any other angle, for any other angle, for any other angle, let us see how much is the range. Range is 2 times, for any other angle, how much is the range? Range is 2 times u squared. Can you see me? For any other angle, if I talk, range is, do you see this beta? You can see this? Okay. For any other angle, if you talk, oops, what is happening? Something wrong with this. For any other angle, range will be 2 times u squared sine theta cos theta by g, and your maximum height is equal to u squared sine squared theta by 2g. For any other angle apart from 45 degrees, range will be given by this formula. Maximum height will be given by this formula. You can always find the ratio of H max by R. What will be the ratio of H max by R for any other angle? It is also true for 45 degrees. You can put the value of 45 degrees and you will get your answer. What will be the value of H max divided by R? You have to divide equation number 2 by equation number 1. Can you do this for me, for anyone? Anyone can do that for me? What will be the value of H max divided by R? Anyone? Divide equation number 2 by equation number 1. What will be the value? What will be the value? The value will be equal to, I think, 1 by 4 tan theta. The value will be equal to 1 by 4 tan theta. Anyone got this? Anyone got this? The value will be equal to 1 by 4 tan theta. Now here, if I put theta as 45 degrees. Now, if I here put theta as 45 degrees, theta as 45 degrees, I will get the ratio at 45 degrees. H max divided by R will also become max. That will become tan of 45 is 1. So this ratio will then become 1 by 4. And this is exactly what we got when we put the angle as 45 degrees in the derivation. Am I clear? Do we understand this, everyone? Anyone has any doubts, please raise up, because I am almost done with the theory part and now we are going to discuss some questions on this. No doubt? Shall I move with some questions? Everybody is ready for the questions? Anyone has any doubt? You can raise the doubt now. What we have done so far, we have seen the formula of time of flight. We have seen the formula for maximum height. We have seen the formula for range. We have seen that time of flight and maximum height depends on vertical velocity. It does not depend on horizontal velocity, but range depends on both horizontal as well as vertical velocity. And now we'll be discussing some questions based on this, so that this concept of using these things that we have learned can be utilized. So here comes your question, and I'm obviously taking your question from your notes. I hope you can see this. Problem number 20. I think this is from your state, Karnataka CET, 2003. Okay, for a given, Hyderabad is not in Karnataka anymore. Anyway, for a given velocity, a projectile has the same range R for two angles. The range is same for two angles. If T1 and T2 are the time of flight in the two cases, what will be the value of T1 multiplied by T2? Anyone? And the answer is, as Jasmine has said, B. What are the two angles for which the range will be same? Anyone? We have discussed this in the class. Range is same for complementary angles. Do we remember this? Range is same for complementary angles. No, Jasmine. Range is same for complementary. Have you read the question, everyone? Yes, Anna. You are right. Range is same for complementary angles. So T1 and T2 are time of flights for the complementary angles. T1 will be equal to 2u sine theta by g. T2 will be equal to 2u cos theta by g. We have discussed this in the class. When you divide T1 by T2, you will get tan theta. When you multiply T1 and T2, you get 2 times R by G. So it is proportional to R. Now that is what, if you remember, you can, without even solving this question, you can mark the answer. The answer is R. That is the benefit of doing these small things. Do you understand this? That is the benefit of doing these small things and remembering them. Am I clear? Okay, Deepak. That was problem number 20. Problem number 21. Straightforward question. These are the type of questions that make our morale high and keep us talking. Problem number 21. A ball is thrown with a velocity of 9.8 meter per second. So this is you. 9.8 meter per second at an angle of 30 degree with the horizontal. Now remember, whenever a question comes, always see whether the angle is with the horizontal or with the vertical. To confuse you, they might give you angle with the vertical. Don't get confused. Remember it. The problem that we have done, we have solved, is with angle with the horizontal. If the angle is given with the vertical, subtract it from 90 and get the angle from horizontal. Am I clear? Okay. So it will hit the ground after how much time? That is what it is asked. I throw the ball with a velocity of 9.8 meter per second at an angle of 30 degree. After how much time will it hit the ground? So basically what they are asking, the thing that they are asking is the time of flight, yes or no? So we just have to find the time of flight. And how much will be the time of flight? Time of flight is simply 2 times u sine theta divided by g. Just put the values, get the answer. Problem number 21. Put the values, get the answer. 2 multiplied by 9.8 multiplied by sine of 30, which is half, divided by acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.8. and your answer would be 1 second. So the time of flight would be 1 second. Am I clear? Do we understand this concept? Yes, Deepak, absolutely clear. Now, if I ask one more question here, what would be the time taken to go from lowest point to the highest point? How much time will it take to go from the point of protection to the maximum height? How much time will it take? If the question was, how much time it takes to reach the top, to reach the highest point, and the answer, Hannah, is 1/2 second. How did you get 1/2 second? We first found out the time of flight, divided by 2, or simply write, time taken to go up is equal to u sine theta by g or u y by g. Can I have some raise hand if you understand this question, sir? This is very simple, pretty damn simple. Nothing has complicated. Nothing has been complicated. It is purely simple, straightforward question. Clear? That will take me to the next problem. Very good. Great understanding, everyone. You're making my task simpler. Problem number 25 comes your way. These are the types of problems. This has come many times in JE, mains or advanced. Advanced means the time when it was not mains in advance, it has come in JE. Question number 25, problem number 25. For a given angle of protection, the horizontal range is doubled. Horizontal range is doubled. Angle is same. Read the question carefully. Range is doubled. Angle remains same. What happens to the time of flight? Waiting for your answers. Waiting for your answers. Angle. Read the question carefully. Just once. Read it carefully. Think. Take a deep breath. Give me the answer. And what is the answer for problem number 25? What is the answer for problem number 25? Range is doubled. Angle remains same. So how can I double range? How can I double range when angle is same? I can only double range keeping the same angle by increasing velocity. Now, range, shall I do it here? I'll do it here. This is problem number 25. I know the formula for range. Range is, you can write it in many ways. I will write it like this: u square sine 2 theta by g. I have written range like this. Now, as you can see here, my angle is constant. G is definitely constant. So I know that r will be proportional to u square. Range is doubled, means range becomes 2r. From r, it becomes 2r. So the new range is 2r. So what will be the new velocity? What will be the new velocity? Range is proportional to u squared. So to make the range twice, the new velocity must becomes root 2 times of u. Yes or no? Do we understand this? To make range double, the velocity must become root 2 times of u. Velocity increase. New velocity is root 2 times of u. Now look at the time period. We were asked about the time period. Time period is directly proportional to u sine theta. Theta remains same. That is why we must remember the formula in all different types. U sine theta, ux, uy in all different types. The time period is proportional to u. Now u has become root 2 times of u. So new time period t dash becomes root 2 times t. Am I clear? Do we understand this? Am I clear? Do we understand this, everyone? Can I have some reason that we understand this, sir? Great. So I'll end the class here and I'll ask you to do the rest of the problems from the notes. There are solved examples. You might not be able to do all. But try. See how many problems you can do. We'll discuss some of them. Up to where? Okay, good question. So you will try up till Question number 25, we have already discussed. So you will try up till 20, 29, 30, 33, 36, 37. You will have to try up till 48. Problem number 48 is what you will try up to the end of this chapter. You should not try the problems on equation of trajectory because we have not done equation of trajectory. So up till question number 48, try as many problems as you can. In the next class, we'll be only dealing with problems. So be prepared for tomorrow. See this lecture again. Be prepared for tomorrow. We'll be coming back and discussing and taking all the problems from here. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Else, from my side, this class is off. You can take a break now. Class is dismissed. Let me save this. Save it as PDF. So from my side, the class is over. Enjoy.